You know, I was reading about Siamese cats. Although Roman and Macey are not full blood, purebred, I guess you call them. Their dad is. Their mom's an alley cat. But these guys, him and Macey, seriously, are different than our other cats. And I don't mean the coloring. I'm talking about the way they act, the way they carry on. I'll let you out in just a minute. I'm talking. I was reading where Siamese are affectionate, you know, and sometimes they choose a person. I mean, they like everybody in the family, but they choose a person to sometimes kind of hang out with more, you know, kind of their person. And I think Roman has probably liked that. And I think he's chosen Gigi. Now, he likes me. But when it comes time to kick back, relax, he'll climb up on Gigi's chair and sit up there and like a love on the back of her head. Now, when Seamus gets up there, Seamus is up there to play. He'll pull on her hair and do wild, crazy things. But it's kind of strange. Little Macey, I think, has chosen me. Wherever I go, whatever chair I sit in is where she's going to come and sit. And just love. She'll hop up on my chair sometimes and just love. Take her little nose, just rub my chin. Maybe it feels good. I don't know. The hair on my chin. I don't know. Have no idea. But she's love away for a couple of minutes, and then she's happy, and away she goes. She don't do nobody else that way. But now, she will desert me at night, but I figured out what that is. She'll come on my bed and lay for a minute, and then she leaves, and it's because of Heidi. Heidi is grumpy. She'll go, like it. And Macey says, I better just get out of here. Now, Heidi won't do that to Roman, though. Roman can lay down beside Heidi, snuggle right up to her, and it's okay. I guess because she knows Roman better. They've been around each other a lot longer. And Roman sometimes will get on the couch with Heidi and lay by her. And nobody else will. So I guess they get along. But that's why Macey deserts me at night, because of Heidi. And that's okay. She's my girl during the day. And I get up in the morning, go get my coffee. Here she comes. Around my feet. I sit down in my chair, start looking at emails around my feet. Then she'll get up there and love on me a little bit. Really neat. I think it says something about them being a little bit kind of hyper. I think I was reading one article. And yes, they are. And they play constantly. If Roman's in, or Seamus, Macey would play with them also, but she plays that little dog, Kippy, all day long. All day long. Until it's nap time. Then they all crash. Where's Kippy at?
Outside.
Okay. There's Kippy. Let Roman out if he wants out. Come on, Bandit. Bandito. I love you, boy. Mm-hmm. Self. Gigi laughs. She'll tell Alex. She says, I love you. He go, like, I love you too, but kind of just a mumble. I do it to pick him. All right, guys, I'm gonna cut this off. I'm just sitting here relaxing, cooling off. All right, folks, Pawpaw here. Yeah, who else looks like it? It's time to go pick up little Macey. She was spayed today. And we dropped her off this morning at the vet's office at 7 a.m. That's the time our apartment was. We got up this morning about 5:30 and excuse me, and took her to Humble. And I'm on my way now to pick her up. Gigi can't go because Gigi's got babies. So I'm going to go pick her up. I know she's waiting to get back with her pawpaw. and I'll show you more about it when I get there. So, buckle up and hang on. You got your seatbelts on? You better have them on. Papa's going to town, going to the big city. Alone. I don't know Jesus telling me how to drive. So here we go. Those folks down there ain't seen nothing. They see Pawpaw driving up.
Well, I'm here to get my baby. My little girl. Texas Litter Control. It's kind of a discount, but they do it. It's real veterinarians in here, folks. They're real. They donate their time to help control litters. Makes sense, doesn't it? All right, I'm going to go ahead and get my baby girl. Here's my baby girl. Hey, Mace. Mace has been spaded. Macey Mara. I can't take you out of the car, baby. The vet said that they give you some pain medication for tomorrow morning and then tomorrow night. And there's all the instructions. They do a good job here. These vets volunteer to do this stuff, and the rates are pretty cheap. I'm trying to see what it says. I don't know how much they charge me. It's $138. They give her rabies shots. And another shot like for leukemia or something like that. That's my baby girl. And if she has any kind of issues, you bring them back and they take care of it for free. That baby. Pawpaw loves her. Yes. Oh yeah, look at her. Wants her Pawpaw's love. Her wants to love Pawpaw's beard. Yeah, we will as soon as we get home, kid. As soon as we get home, oh yeah, I know, baby. We're gonna love. Just sit and love. Said I can feed her when I get home. He said she probably won't eat. Probably won't eat. But she may, and she said she may throw up. That's all normal, not a big deal. Don't let her go out. That's her. She don't go out anyway. She ain't never been out since she been, I brought her in. I know, baby. She wants to love Pawpaw so bad. She just wants her Pawpaw so bad. But I can't let you out in this car, okay? Because then I got to drive. You be up in my lap. We'll have a wreck. All right, I'm on my way home. She's fine. I love this little girl. I know you're going to sleep with your cheesy tonight, you traitor. Hey, guys, last night, Bandit. Turn this around in here. Last night, Bandit. And I don't know what happened. Bandit, I'm trying to find my seatbelt. Bandit and Kippy got into a little argument over in Gigi's bed during the night. Now, when Gigi's going to sleep, she's out. Bandit gets up. Hang on, folks. I don't know. Oh, I see. I see. Hang on. Hey, buddy, Pawpaw, what are you doing? Well, Pawpaw's having a problem here. Seatbelt is twisted. This little fuzzy thing here, it goes on your shoulder and over the little seatbelt deal. Anyway, they have this argument. Well, little Kippy just gets up and says, hey, I'll sleep with Pawpaw and Heidi. Well, luckily, Heidi was asleep, and she didn't know it. He starts to rear up on the side of my bed. I just pull him up, throw him behind me. Woke up this morning, he's all curled up behind my neck. G says, where's Kippy? Where's Kippy? Right here. What's he doing over there? So, if little Macey here can desert Pawpaw,
Kippy can desert Gigi.
We're on our way home. Look at these outlaws here. They had to come around to the front and come across into the yard. Yeah, you look. I'm looking at you, little girl. These two boys here, I know they were out. I left them out. Oh, them two girls. Macey, we home, baby. This whole operation will start again on Thursday when we take Kippy. We'll take him early that morning, and I'll pick him up late that evening because you have babies like we do right now. Macey, wake up, baby. Most of the way home, I held my hand in here like this, and she was loving my hand. She's asleep again now. He said she's asleep a lot today. All right. I see Jill and them are here to pick up the babies. There, Bay. All right. Someone asked me who Bay was. Bay is Jill's daughter from a previous marriage. And you can say, well, it's like Dustin's stepdaughter or whatever, but we don't look at people like that here. Once you marry into this family, folks, you're part of us. There ain't no step, half, or anything like that. You're here. You're in all the way. Let's go in, Macey. Well, she's back with her friends. She's still a little out of it. Roma's having supper. This guy about to fall off countertop. This is her friends. But she's feeling a lot better. Loved on me all the way home. Didn't you, Mace? Loved on Papa all the way home. That's my girl. That's my little girl right here. Yes, she is. And she went through surgery well. And come Thursday, little Kippy goes. These guys have already been there a year or so ago. That's just lazy there. That's just what we call lazy here. Rob would have been outside all day. He has to come in and eat and get ready for bedtime. I love you, baby girl. I love you. Yes, I do. See your little surgery? Oops. I was trying to show you a little surgery, baby. Come here. Let's just see if we can't show them. I don't know if y'all see it. Get them by the light. See your little surgery? Okay. She says, I don't want to show nobody, Papa. Okay. You ain't got to show nobody. But she's feeling pretty good. All right, Macy's home. She's feeling better. We have to make sure Kippy don't play with her. And she just kind of can't figure out why she got those little stitches on her tummy. And he said it's okay. She's not going to pull them out. It's only natural for her to kind of look around on them. The main thing he says, don't let her go outside. Nah, Kippy, no mouth. Get. Go, Kippy, go. Nah, Macey.
Kippy.
We're not going to play.
Come on.
Seamus, no. Y'all can't play with her. Oh, my goodness. It's going to probably be an all-night thing watching her. Well, Seamus will probably go out at bedtime, but she's feeling better. She wants to play. But we have to be real careful. I'm going to try to show you her little incision, if we can. Yeah, you can see it. They did a good job right there. Whoops. Can Papa look? Let me see. Yeah, you can see it. Yeah. Oh, he loves her. He loves her. Anyway, try to keep Kippy from wanting to wrestle. Try to keep her from wanting to wrestle. And Roman walked by a while ago, and she reached out to try to pull him down. There he comes. Now, I see you, Roman. Roman kind of love Papa, see that? Roman remembers him and Seamus both remember when they went there and got surgery. Anyway, she's home. She's feeling good. She's going to be fine. And on Thursday, little Kippy goes. So I'm going to cut this off. Hope you guys enjoy this little short video. I'll get it out for you early tomorrow morning. Catch you guys later.